The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. They say it's no use to blame the mirror if you don't like the look on your face. Easy, simple, and obvious wisdom, isn't it? But perhaps that's exactly what's wrong with it. It's too easy, too simple, and too obvious. And besides, it's much more satisfying to break the glass, and thus to believe that we have changed everything.
I'm scared.
It's all right. We're here to help you. Now, just be calm.
If I stay with him long enough, he'll kill me. He'll have to. Killing means nothing to him.
Now, you don't have to worry about anything anymore.
He'll kill me, because he isn't human. I don't know what he is, but I know one thing. He's not a human being.
Our mystery drama, The Blue Tiger, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Sam Dan and stars Larry Haynes. It is sponsored in part by Sunkissed Growers Incorporated. I'll be back shortly with Act One. The room is small, narrow, dark, and dingy. The furniture is seedy and nondescript. A window opens on the street, just two stories below. The window is covered by a torn shade. The tall, slender young man looks at his watch. He opens an attaché case. Inside are the parts of an automatic carbine. Without hurry, but with deft, skillful fingers, he assembles the weapon piece by piece. And now the gun is together, a neat, shining piece of machinery. He inserts the clip, and at the last, a silencer over the muzzle. He places his hand inside the shade and raises the window. Now, standing by the side of the window from the street, he sights along the barrel of the carbine. The crosshairs are holding on the door of an apartment house across the street. The door opens. A tall, fat, florid man pauses in the doorway. The crosshairs find his large, heaving chest. A muscle twitches in the gunner's cheek. He draws a deep breath. Slowly, he eases back the trigger, past the slack, and now. The gun coughs twice. Across the street, the fat man collapses on the pavement.
Yes?
He's gone.
When?
Just now.
Where are you?
Across the street.
Across the street?
Yep. Yeah. Hold the phone. There's a lot of noise outside. Hello.
Hey, how can you be standing there across the street?
I'm upstairs in the room.
Get out of there.
Now the streets are boiling with cops. Who's going to figure I'm still around?
Hey, you're crazy.
You telling me how to run my business?
Listen, be careful, huh?
I have to be careful. You owe me $20,000. I'll be around tonight to pick it up. Into that music, huh?
Hey, Leo, where you been?
Out on business.
And what am I supposed to do all night? Hang around?
That's what I tell you to do. I'm gonna shut that thing off.
Okay.
You weren't hanging around all night either. I called you about an hour ago. I wanted you to put up a stake.
Well, I went down for the paper.
Fix up some supper.
Can we go out and eat?
No.
Why not?
Come here.
No, Leo.
You asked the question. I want to give you an answer.
No, please.
Come here, I said.
Leo.
You want to know why we can't go out? That's why we can't go out? Any more questions?
No.
Where's the paper?
What paper?
The paper you said you went out and got.
Oh, that paper.
Where is it?
Leo, don't be mad. I forgot to get it. I meant to get one. Honest, but... I was just so glad to be out in the fresh air.
What did you do?
Nothing. I just went for a walk around the block. Honest, Leo, that's all I did.
Did you talk to anybody?
Who would I talk to?
Go in and make us something to eat.
Oh, sure. I'll put up a great big sirloin right away.
Yes? Yeah, I'll see him. Come in, Joe.
Oh, thanks.
Sit down.
Thank you. Well, what do we do now, Drury?
I'm sorry, Joe. You did such good work on it, too.
What is going to happen?
Well, the whole case is out the window.
It can't be.
He was the witness, the star witness.
Okay, it'll be a little tougher. But we have other witnesses.
Have we?
Well, sure. There's...
There's nobody, Joe. Not anymore. Can you blame him? Look, hasn't the department just demonstrated very dramatically that we're completely unable to protect our witnesses?
Oh, that fat fool. Why did he have to go outside?
You can't expect to keep a man cooped up forever.
Who is the killer?
A top professional, you can bet on it.
He shoots down his men on the street in broad daylight. Nobody sees anything. Nobody hears anything.
I think it's a fellow named Leo.
Leo? Leo who?
I don't know. That's just the whisper around town. He's been kind of active lately. This thing has his signature, kind of like a bolt from the blue. No noise, no excitement. And he seems to like a .30 caliber carbine.
Well, that is who we need then. Leo, whoever he is, I want that Leo. And I want him in the worst way. And I am going to get him.
Now take it easy, Tiger.
We had these animals. The biggest dope ring in the country, the key witness, and now it's gone.
Tomorrow's another day.
Well, I can't be blasé about it.
Now you can't go running off in all directions either.
Well, what do you suggest?
A reward.
Okay. Okay, we'll get the media on it. We'll splash this thing all over the country. How much money can we put
in? No, nothing like that. It's going to be very quiet.
Quiet?
Yeah. We'll spread it through our own sources. We'll send out word that we're willing to make a terrific deal for Leo. Money or whatever else might be needed. You know, somebody who's doing a hard 30 years in jail, maybe we can melt a few of those years away for him, or... You never know. We might find a woman.
I'll get him. With or without help. I'll get him if it takes me the rest of my life.
Take it easy, Tiger. You'll live longer.
Leo.
Yeah?
Leo, do you love me?
Yeah.
You never show it.
I give you enough money, don't I?
Oh, I never get a chance to go anywhere to spend it.
We'll go.
When?
When I say.
Why do you keep whistling that song?
Because I like it.
What's the name of it?
Love's Old Sweet Song.
Oh. Where'd you learn the song?
Didn't you ever go to school?
Oh, yeah. Hey, now it's coming back to me. Where'd you go to school?
What's the difference?
You know, you never talk about yourself. You never talk about anything.
You want to hear talk? Listen to the radio.
Sometimes I'd like to talk to you.
About what?
Just about anything.
I like people who know how to keep their mouths shut.
Oh, sometimes I can go nuts.
You knew what you were getting into and you started to make a play for me.
Yeah, but I
told you what it would be like, but you said you loved me.
I do, Leo, I do.
I don't believe it. You didn't love me then, you don't love me now.
Leo, listen.
Who's kidding who? I'm a good deal for you. Just remember, you're not going anywhere unless and until I say so.
I don't want to go anywhere without you, Leo. Oh, believe me, I love you.
Hey, Alice.
Huh?
Hey, you don't remember me, huh, Alice?
Who are you?
It's old Poppy.
Oh.
I was a porter when you was hat check in the Calico Club.
Oh, yeah.
So, what are you doing with yourself, Alice? She's still got great legs.
I'm working in an office.
Uh-huh.
It's been nice running into you, Poppy.
I remember when you left the club, you was starting to go around with a guy. What was his name? Leo?
You remember that, Poppy?
Oh, sure.
Well, it might be better for you if you forgot.
Yeah, well, listen, Alice. The feds want him.
Yeah, well, goodbye, Poppy. Yeah,
Alice, listen. Can't hurt to listen. Believe me. When the feds want a guy that bad, they usually get him. And when they do, they'll bag you along with him.
I don't know what you're talking about.
He's a hoot, Alice. You know it. Sooner or later, he'll get tired of you or you'll get in his way. You got no future there. Now, the feds will give you an awful lot for him. You could be set for the rest of your life.
What makes you think I still know him?
Oh, I always liked you, Alice. And besides, after you make the deal, I figure you could show a little bit of tangible gratitude. A couple of bucks. You'd never miss it.
Yeah, look, I have to go now.
Sure. You go. You think it over. You'll see. I'm right.
Whistle like that all the time? Huh?
Yeah.
I mean, it's bad enough we don't go anywhere.
You go out. You go out during the day, you walk in the park, you go to a movie, you go here, there, the other place. What more do you want?
I don't want anything.
Then what's the beef?
Well, I just wish you'd talk to me sometimes.
About what?
About you. I don't know you. Who are you?
What does it matter?
All I know is that you kill people.
So what? What are people?
What are people?
People are always killing people, all the time, for all kinds of reasons. Who cares about people?
Who cares?
Who really cares? These guys who run the world, what are people to them? What are people to anybody, even to each other? There's not a person who wouldn't sell you down the river if there wasn't something in it for them.
Are you talking about everybody?
Everybody.
Even me?
Yeah, even you.
Well, then why do you trust me?
I don't trust you.
Then how do you know I wouldn't...
I know.
Well, how do you know?
You're too scared. That's why I took up with you in the first place.
Oh.
I had to have somebody.
I thought you were the kind who doesn't need anyone.
I don't. You know, having somebody around isn't the same thing.
And what makes you think I'm so scared?
Oh, come on. I read you like a book. I know everything in your mind.
Do you?
So don't get any stupid ideas. You got a good deal going here. Don't mess it up.
You know who was the first man to say that to a woman? You got a good deal going here and don't mess it up? Why, it was Adam, of course. And he said it to Eve in the Garden of Eden. Is there something inherent in a woman's nature to be restless in the status quo? Probably. But we'll develop all that in Act Two shortly. This is the story of a professional killer. We should introduce a few historical notes. In the olden times, the assassin's trade was quite respectable. They killed according to strict rules of procedure. They were not, for the most part, wayward thugs, as we have today. They were hired for the job, gave value for the money, and for the rest of it, they were good husbands and fathers, like most of their neighbors.
Hello?
Leo.
Yeah?
I have a job for you.
That's good.
Out of town.
The rates are higher.
It's a completely different type of situation.
As long as I can handle it with my usual equipment.
You won't need your usual equipment.
No?
Actually, you won't need any equipment at all.
Then why would you need me?
Because, Leo, you're a man of unusual skill and intelligence. I'll call you again in a few days.
Hey, excuse me. Alice?
Yes?
Listen, I am the man you spoke to.
Oh.
Allison, I had no trouble spotting that red jacket.
Oh, I don't want to talk here. Please, think of a safe place.
All right, now listen, I'll get off the next stop. You go to the one after. Walk back to the hamburger restaurant.
Uh-huh.
It's very crowded.
Yeah.
Now, we can sit at the same table without attracting attention. I'll see you.
Mind if I sit here, miss? Thank you. My name is Joel McKenna.
I'm very frightened.
Yes, it's perfectly natural.
Look, I want to tell you why I'm doing this. I'm scared out of my wits now, but I'm even more frightened when I'm with him.
Yeah, just try to calm yourself.
I worked in nightclubs all my life. I hated it. And I met him. He took care of me. The guys who would otherwise bother me kept away, and I was grateful.
Yes?
Are you really interested?
Sure.
Well, I found out he's with some big outfit. They kind of specialize in getting rid of people. Do you know that?
Yes, we know something about it, but not enough.
Well, I shouldn't have gotten in so deep, but aside from, well, you know, belting me around once or twice, he was very good to me. He still is. So you might ask, why am I doing this?
Yes.
Well, it isn't for the money I'll get out of it. Believe me. Please, believe me.
I do. I believe you.
I would do it for nothing. Except I really would need some money to tide me over till I could learn how to take care of myself.
Yes, I understand.
Now, I'm doing it because if I stay with him long enough, he'll kill me. He'll have to kill me. Killing means nothing to him. Maybe one day I'll do something that really bothers him, and he'll kill me. He won't mean anything by it, because, you see, he isn't human. That's the whole thing. He's not a human being. I don't know what he is, but I know he's not a human being. Do you understand?
Yes, I think I do.
No, you don't. You have to live with him the way I do. I've got to get away from him. I've got to get out. Help me.
Well, that is why we are here.
No. He keeps the gun. It's a carbine in an attaché case. It's genuine leather. It costs $200. He looks like a real executive when he carries it.
Does he have any other weapons?
Yeah. He has a revolver. He's got a knife.
Yes, well, we'll have to take him as soon as possible.
Oh, yes, as soon as possible.
Now, will you be able to tip us off when he's home?
Well, you see, he usually calls me an hour or so before he gets home to prepare dinner. He hates to eat out.
Yes, well, it could be hazardous to try to take him on the street. No, we'll get him in the apartment while he's eating. He won't be armed.
No, I don't think so. He'll have put the attaché case away, and he won't be wearing the other gun.
All right, Alice. We will take care of it tonight.
Oh, tonight. I'm scared.
No, you are doing the right thing, Alice, for yourself and for everybody. I want this guy, Alice. I want him badly. And don't you worry. I'm going to take him.
How are you doing, Joel?
Oh, hello, Drury.
Any reaction yet?
Reaction?
Got any leads on our man, Leo?
Huh? Oh, no.
No? I know how you feel. I know how badly you want him.
Do you? I had the case all wrapped up, and he killed my witness. He destroyed 2 years' work.
Don't feel you can do it yourself. I know you'd like to collar him single-handedly, but you're part of a team.
Yeah, I know. Joel McKenna.
Oh, I just want to tell you, he called me a minute ago. He's on his way home. I better hang up.
Hello.
Who is that?
Someone had the wrong extension.
How do you like the steak, Leo?
It's okay.
I have some more in the kitchen.
Sit down.
Oh, well, I just want to get some.
Some what?
Bread.
There's plenty of bread on the table.
Oh.
Why are you so nervous?
Oh, I'm not nervous.
Sit down.
Now, what's the matter?
Oh, nothing's the matter. I just dropped the dish, that's all.
You're lying.
Me? What would I have to lie about?
You haven't finished eating.
Oh, yeah, I have. I'm not hungry.
Mm-hmm.
I better go inside, into the kitchen.
What do you want to go into the kitchen for?
Well, do I have to have a reason? Can I just go into the kitchen?
No, I don't think so.
What are you saying?
You know how they like to set up a guy sometimes? I used to do it a lot that way myself. While he's at the table, eating.
What are you talking
about? They figure he's off guard. He's enjoying a meal.
Leo!
So his friends, who sold him out, sit around with him. And just before he's due to get it, they just kind of disappear. Is that what you did, Alice? Did you set me up?
How can you even ask me such a question?
I just want you to answer it.
No! Why would I?
You forget something, Alice. You know, I can read you like a book. I keep telling you that over and over.
It isn't true. I love you, Leo.
The trick is to bag me at the table before I can make a move.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Shh. Please, don't interrupt.
It's your imagination.
No, I don't have any. But we can find out for sure. You know how?
I don't...
There are two things you'd have to do. First, make sure I'm at the dinner table.
Leo!
And second, see that the door isn't locked so they can come right in. Now, when I came home, I did what I always do. I locked the door behind me. So what we have to find out now is if the door has been unlocked since I came home. If the door is still locked, maybe you're right. Maybe I'm imagining things. But if that door isn't locked...
Well, listen, Leo...
I have to find out, Alice. There's only one way.
Leo! Leo, listen!
It's open, Alice. It's open.
Oh, Leo, maybe you...
Maybe what, Alice?
Maybe you forgot to lock it.
No, Alice, I didn't forget to lock it. I never forget.
But this one time, just this one time, maybe you thought you did.
Tell me what you did, Alice.
Nothing. I swear, nothing.
It's not too late.
Too late?
To tell the truth.
But I...
Okay, I understand. You were scared. Running around with me would be enough to scare anybody, so you made a mistake. Anybody can make a mistake. I understand, Alice. I don't hold it against you.
Well, you
thought you could make a better deal. Now that you see you can't, from now on, things will be different.
Leo,
how
please.
Much time before they get here, Alice?
I didn't mean
it's
to.
It's all right. I said it was all right. Who'd you talk to?
Oh, the Federals.
All right. They promise you money?
Oh, it wasn't for the money, Leo.
What's the guy's name?
McKenna. Joel McKenna.
McKenna, yeah. Yeah, I heard of him. Real gung-ho. I wouldn't be surprised if he tried to take me all by himself. Well, I'll be waiting for him. What does he look like?
I guess you could say he looks like you. Oh, Leo, why don't we get out of here?
I have to attend to Mr. McKenna first.
But we can get away.
What did you tell Mr. McKenna about me, Alice?
I...
Everything, huh?
Well, I...
All right. Don't worry about it. Miss McKenna likes to operate on his own. Could be he hasn't told anybody anything yet.
Are you going to kill him? Leo? Huh?
Going to leave the door unlocked. Let him come in here. I'll be waiting.
Oh, don't do it.
Stand by the side of the window, Alice. First, turn down the light. Now, keep looking down the street. Come on, do as I tell you.
Yeah, yes, Leo. Leo, you've forgiven me, haven't you?
Just keep looking at the street.
I could never do a thing like this again. You know that. Nothing could ever make me. You understand that? I know we'll be better for this. Stronger,
you
really.
You see that car pulling up down the block?
Oh, yeah.
I can smell those cars. Do you see it?
Oh, yes, Leo.
And the guy getting out?
I think so. Yeah, yes.
You sure?
Yeah, he's the one, Leo.
Yeah, he does. He does look like me. And he's all by himself, too. A chump. Now, come in.
What is it?
I don't want you standing near the window.
Where do you want me?
Right here, next to me.
Yeah, but I
don't want you to try to holler something to that cop to try to warn him.
Leo, I wouldn't dream.
Just to make sure.
Leo, what are you... Tell me, Leo. Please, Leo.
I'm just making sure, Alice.
No, Leo, please, not with a knife.
Now, Mr. McKenna, we're all ready for you.
I'm a police officer. Put up your...
Chump, why didn't you have 20 guys with you? Why didn't you have the house surrounded? Okay, I'll go ahead. It'll be the last words you'll ever say, so make them sing.
You won't get away. I'll get you.
Don't count on that.
Persistent, isn't he, this officer? But what does it amount to? Only a dead man's threat. And it's been made to a killer who is seemingly devoid of imagination or even feeling. And yet, well, who knows what can happen in Act 3? He goes through the world the way a shark swims through the water. He leaves no trace. He makes no mark. Like the shark, he kills without pity and without remorse. Like the shark, he seemingly gets no joy from slaughter. And like the shark, he kills because it's the thing he knows how to do.
Drury. No, we have no statement. Joel McKenna was killed pursuing a lead in the line of duty. We know who the killer is, and we intend to spend all the resources of this government to find him. That's all I have to say right now. Oh, you had to be a hero, Joel. You had to be a hero.
Wow, it's a beautiful day, isn't it, Leo?
Beautiful. You're up. You want to hit your tee shot?
Well, let's just sit here and talk, huh? Not a cloud in the sky. Tell me, how are you when it comes to nature, Leo?
What kind of job do you have for me?
Well, it's a situation you won't believe. It's on the West Coast. I think you could use a little change of scene.
So?
Now, there's this elderly lady, very, very wealthy. Now, she owns some land, you think? Some land? About 100,000 acres. We want it.
Make her an offer.
She turned it down. She won't sell.
Why?
Because she wants to keep it in case her son never comes home.
Where is he?
She doesn't know. She doesn't even know if he's alive. Now, this boy was kidnapped when he was about 3 years old, and that's the last she's seen or heard of him.
You mean you can't find a way to make her sell?
You know, certain things you just can't strong arm. Now, we need that land. The location is all set for a turnpike right of way. And besides, there are minerals.
All right, what can I do about it?
Show up.
Where?
At her house.
And do what?
Take her in your arms. Kiss her. And announce yourself as her long-lost son.
Me?
Yeah, you. You see, we saw pictures of the kid. There is a resemblance.
A 3-year-old kid?
Hey, what's the difference, huh? You have the same kind of face, and now something else. You see, this kid had a birthmark.
Oh, that lets me out.
No. On the back of his hand, it was kind of bluish, and it was in the shape of a cat.
Cat?
Yeah, the head of a cat. That is, she thought it resembled a cat. It's actually a tiger. Now, you can make it out on a picture. We can have it tattooed on your hand without any problem.
Now, that's, it's not the kind of job I'm used to.
Well, it's worth double your usual rates.
Now, what kind of a story do I tell her?
You were a kid, you can't remember anything, but you always try to trace your family. Leo, you could always make up a believable yarn. And besides, she'll want to believe you.
Double the rate, huh?
Now, tomorrow, you go to see this guy and arrange for the tattoo.
Just a minute, please. Just a minute, I'm coming.
Oh. Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is, I've gone by the name of Harry Smith all my life, but that wasn't my right name.
Oh, let me see your hand.
Yep.
Will, it's you. I know it's you.
Then you're my mother.
Oh, Will, I've waited so long. Oh, darling boy, come in, dear. Oh, I knew it would happen one day. You would ring the bell, just ring the bell. You see, a mother knows. Even without the birthmark, a mother knows. She always knows. Oh, Will, if only your father was still alive. Oh, sit, dear. Let me get you something to eat.
No, I'm not hungry.
Oh, even without the birthmark? I knew. Your hair, your eyes. Oh, Will, I've had so much love and no one to give it to. Tell me. Now tell me everything that happened.
Well, I don't remember this house or you or anyone else.
Oh, no.
There were these people, a man and his wife. I thought they were my mother and father.
Oh, well, were they good to you? Were they?
Yeah.
Oh, bless them. May the good Lord bless them.
You see, he was killed in an automobile accident. Oh. And then later she became sick.
Mm-hmm.
And before she died, she told me that they found me wandering about in the woods behind their house. They just took me in and raised me.
Oh, there are kind people in this world. Kind, decent people.
Now, I tried to find out who I was, but I didn't even know where to begin or how to go about it.
Oh, how we tried to look for you, Will. How we tried.
And then I was having a cup of coffee one day in a diner,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Mm-hmm.
And there was this kind of elderly man. I noticed he kept looking at my hand. And finally, he noticed that I saw he was staring at me, and he said, I'm going to ask you a very strange question. Do you know who you are? And he said that he was a reporter, retired now, but he remembered this big kidnapping case.
Uh-huh.
They never found the kid or who did it or how or why, but the kid had this funny kind of cat-like birthmark on the back of his hand.
Oh, thank the good Lord for that man, for the providence that brought him into that diner and made him look at your hand.
And when he told me that, I knew. I knew who I was and where I belonged.
Oh, here. You belong here.
Well, Leo, how are we doing, huh? Or should I call you Will Quentin?
We're doing all right.
And you look as if you're working hard, or as if something's on your mind. It's going okay, isn't it?
Sure.
She accepts you?
Yep.
You get her to sell the land?
The land?
Yes, the land. What do you think this is all about? Now look, it has to be soon. That turnpike extension can't be kept secret too much longer. Now, how long does it have to take you, huh?
To do what?
What are we talking about? To get her to turn over the land.
Oh.
Hey, Leo, Are you okay?
I'm okay.
You having a problem?
Problem?
Yeah, problem. Get moving. Now, you got to get her all set up. You'll meet me here tomorrow, and we'll close the deal.
Just the song at twilight. I didn't think young people even knew that song anymore.
Oh, I remember that from school.
Well, your father and I, it was our favorite. School. I missed out on all your school. How was school?
I had a music teacher in sixth grade. She taught us that song.
Ah.
She was a lot like you.
This is really the first thing, the first specific thing you ever told me about yourself. You don't want to talk about it, do you?
Talk about what?
Oh, about what you did all those years. But you don't have to. It's not important. I don't care what you did, Will. I only know I've got you back.
Suppose it wasn't things that were too good.
Oh, my son couldn't do a bad thing.
Don't say that. You grow up in a jungle, nothing matters, nothing counts. Just get ahead of the next guy.
Will, I know you're a decent boy.
Now, Mother, don't say that.
You may have done things that were wrong, but you have the power and the capacity for good. I know it.
I never did anyone any good.
Well, how could you? No one ever loved you. And until you've known love, how can you really tell what's good and what's evil?
No, it's too late.
Oh, no. No, it's not too late. You're home. You can begin again.
Well, you're right on time, Leo. I had such confidence you'd be here, I even ordered you a drink. Did you do it?
Do what?
Leo, what are you trying to pull?
Nothing. The deal's off.
What do you mean, the deal's off?
You heard me.
The deal can't be off.
I'm not going through with it.
Oh. Well, I think I understand. You walked into the setup. The whole thing falls into your lap, so you're holding it all for yourself.
No, I'm not.
Then what is wrong?
I don't want the old lady to get cheated.
But she's getting a good price.
Come on, the land's worth millions.
It doesn't belong to you.
She belongs to me.
What?
I belong to her.
What has gotten into you, Leo?
She calls me son.
But you are not her son.
I have to be her son.
Hey, I don't understand the word you're saying.
Yeah, I know.
And I don't have to. I am just telling you what you had better do.
I have to be her son. There's no way out of it. Do you know why?
No, I don't know why, and I don't care.
Here. Look at my hand.
What about your hand?
You see the tattoo? This blue mark that looks like the head of a cat, the head of maybe a tiger. Do you see it? Now look close.
Yes, I see it. I told you to get it put there.
This mark. This blue head of a cat, maybe a tiger. This mark was on the back of the hand of that federal cop. The one I killed. So what I'm saying is this. Forget about that lady. Forget the whole business. It's over. It's all over.
You can't get away with it, Leo.
My name is not Leo. And I can take care of myself and of you and of anyone else who tries to stop me.
Drury.
I'm calling this special number.
Yes?
For the federal officer that was killed.
Do you have any information? Where on the West Coast?
Now, you just write this down. I'll give you everything you need.
But why must you go away?
Well, it's just for a little while until...
Until what?
Until certain things quiet down, blow over.
Oh, tell me what it is, Will.
No, I can't.
I'm your mother.
Well, these are things that happened before you were my mother.
But you'll be back.
Yeah, I'll be back.
Well, I've waited so long for my son. I can wait a little while longer.
All right, Harry. You and Joe get across the street. Bob, you stay with me. Smitty and his men are around the corner. He has to come this way. Can't get past us. Now, I'll challenge him. We want him alive. But let's not take any chances. And be ready. Someone's coming. Yeah, it's Leo. Okay, stand still. You're under arrest. Don't run. You can't get away. He died as he lived. A hoodlum. He was betrayed, as most of them are, by his own kind. He was a cold-blooded, inhuman killer. If he had any redeeming characteristics, we don't know about them. Now, you could say that he was made of 100% pure venom. That, ladies and gentlemen of the media, is all the questions that I have time for. Thank you very much.
So the question remains, is there anyone who doesn't have even the tiniest redeeming feature? Can anyone really be 100% pure venom? Is there any heart that is all ice and steel? Oh, well, there's always hope. And I hope you shall wait for me to return shortly. The strongest and most important love of all is the first love we know in life, the love of a mother. This is a love that never wavers, never wanes, a love that grows stronger as it grows older. Yes, it's the love from which all other love springs, and the only love which is not shrouded in mystery. It is at once the simplest and most complex love of all. Our cast included Larry Haynes, Bryna Rayburn, Earl Hammond, and Ray Owens. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown.
This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.
Foam and quality upholstery materials puff quilted to a beautiful decorator fabric. Inside, Serta's famous construction gives you the deep support you need. Underneath it all is the patented Certa-Lock foundation. Pillow comfort on top, ultra firm support inside. That's Serta's perfect sleeper pillow soft. Firmness that feels good. So,
be a perfect sleeper.